Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Lisa and I am the Curvy Cuban, and I do primarily colorful eyeshadow looks and palette dupes. Partially because I can't afford every palette that's out there, and partially because I have an arsenal of makeup at my fingertips that doesn't get used enough. So I'll just go ahead and take the inspiration from everybody else's popular looks with all the must-have it palettes, and I'm gonna try to do it myself with what I already have. So, the Huda Beauty Retrograde palette, that is what we're all here to see today. I came up with not one, not two, but three different duped looks from this palette. So everything you see on my eyes is from my own personal makeup collection and not the Huda Beauty palette, you know, the dupes. See what you have in your collection, open up your palettes and see if you can't follow along and create some of the most sought after looks from the most sought after palettes without spending a penny. Just keep on watching. This place is for you. Let's get started. Huda Beauty's website, they had five looks that you have to try with the... Wow, I've just lost my entire train of thought. What is the name of this palette that I'm trying to dupe? Huda.
12 o'clock midnight.
The Mercury Retrograde palette. So it said that there was specific looks for this $67 palette that we needed to try. I'm just gonna start at the beginning of Huda's own website over the looks that they need to try. Start off by placing the shade, either the shades Off Balance, Libra, Karma, or Utopia. So I'm gonna start off and add a little bit of Utopia and Off Balance in my crease. I'm gonna get a little daring, a little crazy. And again, I'm following this must-have look by Huda Beauty themselves. Don't get me wrong, I think the Mercury Retrograde palette is a very pretty palette. And at first glance, it would appeal to me. For their advertising, they showed a lot of separate looks, pink, green, purple, pastel-ish type hues with the corresponding shimmer on the lid. And at first glance, whenever a color lover sees the same look in multiple colors available to you in one palette, that's what screams at you. You're like, ah, color, let me go play with it. The color lover then has to take a step back and think, wait a second, I do love these colors. And I've been loving these colors for a very long time, which is why I bought that palette and that palette and that palette. And it really did not take me long to find dupes for every single shade in the Mercury Retrograde palette. Well, the next shade I'm going to be duping is Libra. I am a Libra. So I'm just gonna blend out some of this Off Balance shade with Libra. I really had wanted to do a pink look in the month of October for breast cancer awareness. Unfortunately, the month of October eluded me so quickly. I didn't even get to do my Halloween video. I did my Halloween video and actually had my Halloween video almost edited, but it wasn't ready to go until November 1st. And I figure a year from now, if I were to put it out, my content will have exponentially increased in quality by then, I hope. So I don't think I would probably go back to this. So to save space on my camera device, I went ahead and deleted all the footage and called it a practice run for my first Halloween in the YouTube realm. But in the meantime, there were a lot of palette releases and I gotta dupe all of them. So let me grab my Karma dupe and then kind of add this to the outer corner. Vortex is like the dark shade in this palette. So I'm gonna grab my Vortex dupe and just tap this out in the outer corner. Just to blend out the edges. The final step that Huda describes for this look is to put Nebula all over the lid, which I will be applying with my finger. I'm gonna do my lashes, liner, and face makeup, and we'll be back so you can see look number one. This is just so simple. We're not doing any cut creases. It's just really a three-step process. I'm just gonna pizzazz it up by putting on some pretty ColourPop mascara in the shade Purple Prose. It for three dupe looks, one palette for the Huda Beauty Mercury Retrograde, and we'll be right back for dupe look number two.
Early the next morning,
I'm gonna start off by duping the shade Vortex. Next one I am duping is Hot Mess. Go with Galaxy, and I'm gonna put that inner corner of my eye. Then I'm going to go in with my dupe for UV. And finally, I'm going to dupe the shade Supernova. I really should have put the other one on the outer portion of my eye, so I'm just going to switch this around a little bit. Rest of my face makeup, and then we will come back to finish up look number two with my dupes. I'm going to go back in with basically the same colors that I used on the top, just darkest to lightest. So we're going to start out with Vortex, then Hot Mess, and then some shimmers. Hot Mess. Galaxy. This will conclude look number two of the three looks that Huda Beauty's website states that you should try with this new palette. Two down, one to go, and we'll be right back for look number three. I almost closed out that look number two without putting on lashes, so this is the final look number two of the three duped looks that I'm going to do with this palette. Okay, now let's move on to look number three. I'm going to start off with the shade Haze, which is the pretty mint green, which you will see in the screen. Now on this palette, there's not a whole lot of super dark shades to really build up a crease. So I'm just gonna continue to build up this color to my desired intensity. This is the point in the look where I would usually grab a darker teal with what's in my collection, but that's not what's in this palette. And since I'm duping this palette, I can't do that. So I'm just gonna start shaping it. I don't know, it feels kind of boring so far, but we'll see. Blend out those outer edges. I really kind of want to play with Galaxy, but obviously Mercury, that deep teal glitter, has to go on the outer corner. I'm going to put some Nebula. To go ahead and quickly do the rest of my makeup, clean up underneath these eyes, and we'll come back for the under eye portion of the video. And we're just gonna pop some mint green liner in this waterline. I mean, it's blue. I don't know what the actual shade name is, though. All right, so we got the blue liner, the mint liner, and for the lower lash line, I really wanted to put Utopia all along the bottom to add a little bit of color in. Just add a little contrast to the look. And it blends in well in the outer corner. It kind of turns to a purplish shade. I'm gonna smoke that out with ultraviolet. Because there are no decent highlighters in this palette, I'm gonna grab my own highlighter. And this is the Alchemist Holographic Palette from Kat Von D, which I got for $6 at TJ Maxx. I'm gonna grab the shade Blue Sapphire, and I'm just gonna add that all over the top of my brow bone. Blend it out. I'm finishing up my lashes, we can go ahead and talk about this palette. I've seen several reviews on the Mercury Retrograde palette, and Most of them are pretty underwhelming. I am not gonna lie, I am all about the pretty pinks, purples, blues, and sparkles. Like, that is something that calls to me. So instantly when I saw the palette, that was something that I wanted to dupe because I knew I could, but it was also something that in a past life I would have just jumped on and bought. But then again, maybe not, because I have never spent more than $60 on a palette. I don't even think I've spent $60 on a palette. And all of Huda's big palettes are in the $60+ range. I do have a bunch of the Huda minis, and believe me, I cringed spending $27 or $29 on those 9-pan palettes. I think her stuff is way overpriced, and considering the amount of reviews with people saying that some of the payoff's not great, or they wish it had this or that, or there's a little bit of chalkiness, or the color story didn't suit them, I felt like I heard a lot more negative type reviews rather than positive reviews, and I would be upset if I spent over $60 on a palette and didn't have anything wonderful to say about it. Like, fantastic. I have a whole lot of palettes, and some of them, the quality is point on, spot on for so many specific brands, and I grab and reach for those all the time, not just for one look, but to dupe many of these looks. And then I have some palettes that cost me a pretty good penny, not $60, but in the 50s. And some of the shades are my everything, and some of them are just leave me wondering, like, why did you even put this in here? It's just, the quality is so bad. And I'm talking from high dollar companies, you know, we're not talking cheap palette, cheap quality. I'm talking not cheap palette and some chalky quality. It's really risky when buying these high dollar palettes if you already have the shades in your collection to go and splurge so you can have it all on your fingertips and then be disappointed with the results. This palette particular, just sitting here trying to dupe it, I'm realizing, oh my gosh, I can't add a deeper teal into the crease. That's what I'm missing. I'm missing some darker hues to complement this look. In that aspect, if you get this palette and you like to have a darker crease and a darker outer corner, you're not gonna find that shade in this palette. Not, you can't get the entire look with one palette. So that's a little disappointing. I do think it's nice for a nice, flirty, ethereal pop of color. Like, you could put down the mint green and just the teal shimmer on the lid and call it a day. You could do the same thing with some of the pinks. But for me, I do a little bit more high detail in my work and in my looks, and it's a little too simplified at way too high a price point. I also have a little white lie. I wonder if adding a pop of white would look okay. If not, I'll go over it in purple. What I love about that is it finally makes it look like I have lower lashes. That is bold. Okay, I'm gonna go over it with purple. And I'm gonna spray down with some of my Becca Skin Love Glow Shield Prime Mist and Set. And there you have it. Not one, not two, but three different dupe looks from the Huda Beauty Mercury Retrograde Palette, which I did not buy and clearly do not need to. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. I really appreciate you sticking around and checking out all the different looks. I hope you get your makeup out and find the creative genius within yourself to see what you can duplicate instead of having to go out and spend all that coin on all those new palettes. There are so many palette releases that I can't keep up with the videos to dupe. Haven't even gotten to Tati's palette yet, and I don't know if I'm going to, because I really want to dupe the Melt Cosmetics release with the Vida and Muerto. Oh, that's a palette I want to buy with everything in me, except I have never spent any money like that on some palettes, and I've never bought anything from Melt, although I've always wanted to. So that is my next mission, to dupe the Melt Cosmetics palette. So be on the lookout for that. In the meantime, you'll probably see a salt and pepper sprinkling of just some regular looks that I have that I really need to get edited and out of there, get you some content. And until next time, stay curvy and stay competitive, and I'll see you in a week. Bye.